Welcome everyone, this is Like It's 1985, and this video is a response to a YouTube user Baraki808. His video question is, do you go with the officially licensed Bandai product when you're buying your model kits, or do you go with a knockoff such as TTHongli? Now, the answer to that question for me is a little mixed. If, for example, you have a Bandai kit that's, maybe $10 to $15 more expensive than a TTHongli knockoff, I probably just, out of guilty feelings, would choose the Bandai product, just because I want to support Bandai in that regard. However, there are some cases where the price of the knockoff is so much more cheaper than the officially licensed Bandai product, that I'm willing to at least consider, if not purchase, a knockoff model kit. So, to use an example of what prompted this whole response, I guess, is I was really impressed with Prime 92's evaluation of the Master Grade Sinanju TTHongli knockoff kit. She did a review recently, and I like the mobile suit design enough, and I trusted Prime 92 enough that I said, hey, let me go ahead and try to pick up a TTHongli knockoff Sinanju Master Grade kit. Now, in my search, I can tell you that there's quite a difference. As of February 21st, 2010, Hobby Link Japan is selling the official Bandai Master Grade Sinanju kit for 7,000 yen, which is roughly $70. Moving on to Rainbow 10. Apparently, what they're doing is they're selling the Bandai Sinanju Master Grade kit for 5,600 yen, or roughly $56. Moving on to HobbyWave.com. HobbyWave.com is listing this Bandai Sinanju kit for $79. That's $79. Going to Gundam Store and More, you're going to be paying $75 for the Bandai Sinanju Master Grade kit. If we look on eBay, and I type in the words MG and Sinanju, and sort them from lowest to highest, the lowest price I can get on this for the Master Grade Bandai Sinanju is $54. And finally, if I go to do a Google search on MG and Sinanju, and also, go to Google Shopping and arrange from lowest to highest price. Excuse me. The lowest price I can see here is $61. Now, if I go to Walter Hobby store, look up the Sinanju, and it's selling for the low price of $27.90. Now, this is the $27.90, this is the TTHongli knockoff version. Yes, people, I do admit that if there is that much of a price difference, I will go with the knockoff. And that's because of two reasons. One, the low price, but two, because Prime 92, gave it a good review. She gave it a positive review. Now, granted, she is sponsored by Walter Hobby, which does sell the TTHongli kits. But I have no reason to not trust what Prime 92 says. I think she's an honest person, so that leads me to say, okay, I want the Sinanju kit. I'm into Transformers at the same time, so if I can save on a model kit with Gundam, then that will give me more money to spend on Transformers or whatever else, and it'll be easier on my wallet. But again, if it's going to be a price that's like $10 or $15, and the Bandai is that much more expensive, I would go for the Bandai just to support them. I don't know, maybe out of guilt. I don't know. these products right here, these are all Bandai products. And up until now, I have purchased all Bandai products. So, it's really Prime 92's review and this whole debate, discussion, whatever, of Bandai versus TTHongli that's gotten me thinking about, would I buy a knockoff? And I think I would. Now, there are a couple of catches with ordering from Walter Hobby Store that I've noticed. Throughout the weekend, I tried to place an order. But it said when I got to the point where I was actually paying it with PayPal said that Walter Hobby was unable to take payments at this time. So I don't know. There must be some problem. And coupled along the fact that they had some website issues, I think it was yesterday. So, you know, it's going to be, you're going to run into those issues. And the other issue you got to deal with is shipping. Now, they do offer relatively low shipping, you know, $12 for shipping overseas. However, with that low price in shipping, you're going to have to wait 25 to 40 days. Now, it does say that clearly in the checkout, you know, so there's no hiding that fact. They're honest and upfront about that. And in all honesty, if it's easier on my wallet, I don't mind waiting 25 to 40 days. You know, that extra money I'm saving from buying the officially licensed Bandai kit, I can spend on Transformers or whatever else I want to spend money on. I don't know. Does that make me a bad person? Is this ethical for me to do this? The fact that I'm buying from a company that's ripping off Bandai products? At the end of the day, if it's easy on my wallet, I can live with it. You know, whenever I can, I'll support Bandai, but, you know, if it comes down to that much of a price difference, see ya, Bandai, I'm going with TTHongli. And keep in mind, I have only Bandai officially licensed model kits. It's only now that I'm thinking about getting a TTHongli kit. And if I can ever get my order placed, I will have a TTHongli Sinanju in about 25 to 40 days. I've also heard some people say, well, you know, the knockoffs are all crap. They're you know, don't buy them at all. But I think that might be somewhat of a sweeping statement that, you know, true, maybe 99.95% of the, you know, TTHongli knockoffs are crap, but there's still the possibility that there's a small percentage or a fraction of a percent of them that maybe not be so bad. You know, the case in point, that, you know, the Prime 92 reviewed the Master Grade Sinanju knockoff, and she said she was pretty pleased with it, you know. And some people say, well, you know, she's a modeler, she knows how to modify this stuff. And that may well be true as well. You know, she may not have a problem, you know, cutting into plastic and gluing stuff together and making it look good in the end. But you know what? At the end of the day, I want to find out for myself. You know, I don't consider myself an expert modeler by any means. But I want to find out as well. I'm kind of curious to find out, you know, is it really that good of quality? You know, in the case of the Sinanju, is that really that good, even though it's a knockoff? I kind of want to find out. So that's kind of my other reason for wanting to get a TTHongli product. I know that when I went to Thailand and they had a market there, they had bootleg copies of, you know, this is back in 89, so they had bootleg copies of like Paula Abdul albums and Debbie Gibson albums. Like, and as a teenager with little money, I was like, oh, sweet, $1 for a whole Debbie Gibson album or $1 for a whole Paula Abdul album? Yeah, I'm so on to that. I don't know. That's kind of how I feel with the TTHongli. It may be wrong. It may be unethical. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's going to be easier on my wallet than so be it. And it kind of comes from my opinion. And it's just my opinion. I don't have any concrete examples to give you. But I think in some cases the Bandai model kits are just too expensive. And I realize that some people are pointing out, well, Bandai kits in the world of model kits are the cheapest model kits, you know, relative to other model kits. And I have no reason not to doubt that. But I still think that some Bandai products are just way too expensive. And part of it's got to do with, you know, them being imported. But still, you look at, you know, like if you look at Hobby Link Japan, that's a local, you know, outlet in Japan. Even in Japan, you're going to be paying 7,000 yen or $70. And then for those of us across the pond, we still got to pay shipping. So I don't know. I think in some cases the Bandai products are just too expensive. Yeah, that's all I got. Hopefully you won't hate me, but you know, I just have to be honest with myself and everybody else that hey, in some cases I will buy a TTHongli knockoff. That's just the way I am. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. Until the next review, bye.